Airbus and Boeing have over the years risen and become the leading aerospace titans in the world, having provided nearly 90% of the total aircraft population in the world. Having existed for so many decades, the two giants have ushered in a golden age of air travel through the provision of different aircraft, both big and small, which are suited for different sectors of the aviation market. But despite having control over nearly all sectors of the aviation market, there is one sector in which both companies have never been able to adequately cater for. That is the small aircraft sector, a market sector in which both companies tried to venture in but failed. As a result of this, other smaller aerospace companies like Bombardier and Embraer rose and became juggernauts on this market sector, which their counterparts failed to successfully venture in. But luckily for Airbus, with the latest addition to their aircraft lineup, the Airbus A220, an aircraft which was originally designed by Bombardier and has proven to be the perfect small aircraft whose efficiency has largely remained unchallenged by aircraft from the likes of Boeing and Embraer, making it the right aircraft at the right time. As a result of this, the Airbus A220 may just be the luckiest aircraft in the world. But how is that so? Let's find out. Before we even find out why the Airbus A220 is the world's luckiest aircraft, first we need to understand how Airbus managed to acquire the plane. But before that, let me explain why Airbus and Boeing failed in the small aircraft sector. As a way of catering for the small aircraft sector, both Airbus and Boeing offered shortened versions of their popular models. For Airbus, they tried to do so with the Airbus A318, a shortened version of the Airbus A320 family, while Boeing offered their Boeing 737-600, a shortened version of their popular Boeing 737. Sadly, these two planes never became successful. The Airbus A318 just received orders for 80 planes, while the 737 just received orders for 69 planes. These planes failed mainly because they were too big and also they lacked the efficiency of a typical small airplane like the ones produced by Bombardier and Embraer. Now, let's move on to the Airbus A220. As I had mentioned earlier, this plane wasn't built by Airbus, but was built by the Canadian aerospace company Bombardier. Bombardier had foreseen the need to develop a small aircraft sitting between 100 to 160, and therefore they launched the C-Series program, which eventually became the Airbus A220. To increase on efficiency, Bombardier adopted the use of lightweight composite materials to make the wings and body of the plane, and also the plane was given new advanced avionics, high bypass turbofan engines, etc. And later on, the plane made its first flight on September 2013 and it entered service with the launch customer, Air Baltic. The C-Series had two variants, the CS-100 sitting between 108 to 133 and the stretch CS-300 sitting between 130 to 160. For Bombardier, they knew that by selling this plane to the American carriers, it would highly contribute to the success of this program. But Boeing wasn't ready to let this happen. This was because the C-Series planes would drop the Boeing 737-700 off its market among the US carriers. Sadly for Bombardier, things were about to get really messed up. Bombardier knew that by getting an aircraft order from a major US carrier like American, Delta or United Airlines, it could help break the Airbus Boeing duopoly in the US. As a result, they sold Delta Airlines a whopping 75 aircraft at 70% discount off the list price of $71 million, making the final sale between $24 to $28 million per aircraft, meaning they sold the planes at a loss in order to attract the favor of the US carriers. This attracted so much backlash from Boeing, who accused Bombardier of dumping. Dumping occurs when a country or a company exports or sells a product at a price that is lower in the foreign market than it is in the exporter's domestic market, and therefore Boeing filed a dumping petition against Bombardier for a total duty of nearly 300% on the C-Series planes offered by Bombardier to the US carriers. Luckily for them, Airbus stepped in. Because of these dumping petitions filed by Boeing against Bombardier, it initiated the partnership between the company and Airbus, who acquired 50.01% of the program, leaving Bombardier with 34% ownership and the Quebec government with 16% ownership of the program. By taking a majority stake on the C-Series program, Airbus moved production of the aircraft to its production facility in the US, which technically made the plane a US-made airplane, and eventually the tariffs imposed on Bombardier were lifted. After Airbus acquired the program, they renamed the C-Series into the Airbus A220, and that's how the Bombardier airplane became an Airbus airplane. Later on in February this year, Airbus increased its share to 75% as Bombardier exited the program while the Quebec government held the 25% balance. Now, let's look at why the Airbus A220 is a game changer. For one, the plane itself is small, making it the perfect airplane during and after COVID-19. Its small size makes it easier to fill, which makes it profitable as compared to filling the larger planes, which are much more difficult to fill as a result of the reduced demand for air travel brought by COVID-19. Secondly, the plane is very young and very fuel efficient. The new technologies available on the plane, such as the new lighter body, advanced avionics, new engines, etc., make the plane very profitable to operate. The success of this airplane has led to airlines requesting an even larger variant of the type with a potential Airbus A220-500 in consideration. Since the Airbus A220 is a versatile aircraft offering unbeatable fuel efficiency, long range, rare passenger comfort, etc., a stretch version with more seats would further extend the success of this small airplane, therefore increasing the profit margins for airlines which will operate the plane. With this plane also available as a business jet, it's set to take the private market by storm. Recently unveiled by Airbus with the name ACJ220, the aircraft has broken the boundaries for a new market segment, with the aircraft featuring state-of-the-art stunning and lavish interiors with unmatched personal space and signature designs. I think we can all agree that the Airbus A220 is the world's luckiest aircraft, which came at the perfect time. The plane is a remarkable aircraft which will soon become a must-have for airlines, making Airbus hopeful that its little A220 will most certainly transform the airline industry. So, what do you think about the Airbus A220? Let me know your thoughts through the comment section. And if there's anyone out there who has ever flown on this airplane, how was the experience like? Do let us know through the comment section. As always, thank you very much for watching this video, and in case you're new here, my name is Martin and welcome to the Skyline, and please subscribe for more great aviation content. Otherwise, thank you very much for your time and I'll see you next time. Have a nice time ahead and please take care. Goodbye.